Alright, hello everyone. Let's go ahead and start the demo of this multi-instance, right? I'll go ahead and start to log in into the FXOS, which is the Firepower Chassis Manager. Right. And this is the overview page, which is first loaded when you log onto your FCM, the Firepower Chassis Manager, and you'll get a view, something like an overview of everything running on your FXOS or on your Firepower. So here you can see the model. In my demo, I'm running on a 4110, and then there is a version 2.12.0.31, and it's currently running. Operational state is operable, so it's good, right? And then down here you see certain view or some visible information about the appliance, right? Some color coding, green color show it's okay, it's running, it's good. The power, both modules are good. And then the name of modules, and you can even just, I guess you can just click and then hover over, and then you will just show more information. There are other details which we will go into really shortly, but before that I thought of just start by another portion, which is how do you get the downloads, right? And as you remember, we're running on this version 2.12. let's see how do we get the version. Okay, so first of all, let's go to your cisco.com. And then when you want access to the download, so you need to go to support. And then on the top left, look for this products and downloads. Then just head over at the bottom of downloads, right? And just click on all downloads. So it might ask you to log in. So because you need to log in order to be able to download, right? So from here, you can just search for the products directly if you know what you're searching for. So for instance, maybe for my case, I can just type Firepower. And if I know my model 4110, it will be even easier, right? I also thought of showing you how to start from scratch. So you want to go and start from browse all. On the left, this panel, just go all the way down to security. Look for firewalls, and then a couple of choices here, then just go to next gen firewall and choose the version of your appliance or your hardware model, right? So in this case, for my case, it's 4000 series and 4110, and then underneath here just look for this one, right? FXOS Firepower Extensible. So if you're looking for other software, you can access via the same place, right? Like FTD or other things like the Firepower migration tools. But what we want to proceed is this one, Firepower Extensible OS. And yeah, you will see it will just load with the latest release, 2.10. And then you do have other options as well. So for instance, the one that we were running is 2.12. And yeah, it's 2.12 here. Then I guess I'm running this one. I can even just try to download the latest version. So we always recommend to check out the release note to know what are the bug fixes, what are the release, and what are the features that you are getting, right? So just for example, all the way down. So this is the one, FXOS image. So I can just go ahead and download this, right? And when I click on this, it will prompt me to put in my CCO ID, and then I can proceed for download, right? So this is the really quick way for you to look for the FXOS image, right? Okay, let's get back to FCM. So first thing, after you downloaded your FXOS image, so you can come over to system updates. And if let's say you're uploading a new image, upgrading a new one, then you can go ahead and click this upload image here, browse to your image, choose a file, browse to your image and then upload. Then it will take some time to update the platform. So these are the available updates that I'm having currently, 2.12. Okay, you can see and you can tell from the status, right? The status itself, just sort by date. Right, 2.12. So this is the one by the status is being installed. Okay. And you can just switch the image if you need to. So that's a real quick one. I'm not going to update the FXOS because my 2.12 is quite okay. So I'm just moving on. So next, what you want to do is to go over and look at the security engine, right? So move over here, security engine. And a couple of things here, like the hardware status, service status, and yeah, the application. So the recommendation, if you are starting to upload or starting some new instance, so we will recommend you to do initiate with this button here with a setting called inside, right? So you hover over your mouse and then you will see this reinitialize security engine. So you can just click on that and it will ask you to, for the confirmation, you can just click on that, yes, and then it's going to reinitialize something like just formatting that engine and then make it ready to start porting in the new logical devices. But for my case, I'm not going to do that because my security engine is already reinitialized, right? So next, I will head over and continue with my resource profile creation. So I'll just go over to platform settings. Then down here on the left, look for resource profiles. And yeah, you can see that I have something already created. So the first one was created by the system. It was automatically created. Right, that was with 6 CPU cores. And then I already have this demo profile called XCPU cores. And then I named that medium. Okay. So if you want to know how many CPU cores that you have currently, you can check it out from your logical devices. And notice up here you have this. 14, for my case, 14 of 22. That means I'm having a total 22 cores available, right? So I already using 14 of, I'm using 8 of them. So I can still make use of the 14 left, right? So I already have one FTD running, and then yeah, it's running on version 7.1, and I'm going to create another FTD on top. So I'm continuing from where I was just now, which is the resource profile. So we know that I can create 14, right? So I can just create a profile for the resource. So I'll just say stable, where I just put it large, right? Give it some description. I'll say, yeah, maybe I'll just use 12. It's just a demo anyway. And yeah, and it helps if you put the cores in the name. You will know why later. 12. Okay, we have a note here, specify even value. So that means we don't recommend you to put odd number. I don't think you can put 11, so let's just go with even. Okay, so my resource profile is created. And next, I will want to go and create my interface. And before that, if you want to create your interfaces, you can do so. You can check it out. See, all right. So there's a couple of interfaces here. And then data interface will be dedicated by instances, right? Like mentioned earlier. And then you can also create new one. For instance, you can add the port channel, you can change it to data sharing, or you can even like create the sub interfaces and tie it to certain interfaces, right? So for my case, I already have interface 1/2 and 1/3 used by FTDA. And then I'm going to create and just make use of 4 and 5 for FTDB, right? So how do I make use of that? I need to create a logical devices. So next, I'm going to my logical devices. And then I will go ahead and add a standalone instance. So give it name FTDB. We'll be using Firepower Threat Defense. And for my case, for FTDA, I'm already running 7.1. So in certain example or certain network from your customer, that could be a current FTD running. So you can make use of these features. Like probably you just want to set up another instance just for testing. For instance, maybe I just want to test on 7.2. Okay. Then instance type, I'll just choose container. And yeah, so you'll say, yeah, it will recommend to reinitialize, but now obviously I do not need to do that now because I already reinitialized that before I created FTDA. So yeah, so I just do it. Okay. All right, and start with the provisioning of the logical devices, right? So I will choose 1/4 and 1/5. To be used by this FTD instance. Then I'll click on this logo here, TD7.2, click to configure to enter the configuration as settings. Okay. So remember the resource profile that we created earlier? So here you can see that. And that is the reason why I recommend if you want to put in more description into the name. So for my case, I know demo large, and from here I know this is a 12 course, right? I'll just go ahead and assign the management interface. So this depends on every network, but for my case it's 1/1, which I already predefined earlier. And yeah, so this demo is on IPv4. So let's see, my IP address will be 98.13.133.12. Okay. Yeah, just go ahead and continue with the rest of the configuration. My gateway. Right. What's the IP? Then before I click OK, I just move on to the middle tab, which is the settings, to continue with the bootstrap configuration. I will want the permit for FTD SSH. Yeah, we'll look at that shortly. Some domain information. So my case is the cloud.local router mode. Some of the rest of the information, like DNS. And the password. Yeah, sure. Lack of one character, obviously. Right. And this is where you put in your FMC IP. Right. It's mine. And put in the net ID just in case that's required as per the net settings. So mine is quiet. And for my case, I just ignore the eventing the phase. So the next one, the agreement, right? So this is already grayed out and already already checked. So I guess I'm done. I'll just go ahead and click OK. And yeah, one more step, which is to hit the save button top right. So the moment when I hit this save, it will start the backend provisioning and creation. Right. So notice it's starting to, yeah, okay. And notice this status is flashing, installing. And at this point of time, the installation is running. Usually it will take like, depending on your hardware, it will take some time. So yeah. So this is how to create an instance on the right on the web UI, and you can also check all the details from the CLI. Let me just show it real quick. FTP chassis. So I'll log in via the CLI. Right. So there's some settings here, but you just need to remember we need to start from using the scope to jump through the module and the slots, right? So you can do a scope, do a question mark, then you see some options that you can jump to. But what we want to go to is this SSA, the security services. Okay, then I can do a question mark. Let's just start with scope, and then question mark, then move ahead to slot. Depending on the appliances, you can choose a different slot based on the setup. So for my case, it's slot 1. And notice this looks like a directory in front. So you can jump back to the previous level by just doing exit. Notice it jump back to SSA, right? So if I'm at SSA, I want to go back to the place just now. I just redo, let's scope slot 1. Okay, so let's see what else I can do here. I can show, I can even just go into, the app instance. I guess I can just show app instance. And notice I have some details here. Can I expand that? Right, so FTD-A, FTD-B. So FTD-A is the one already in place, 7.1. And then I have this FTD-B, it is starting, right? So I can check back and see the status. Okay, I can